going to carve a new spoon, and I've been up in the woods, and I harvest this piece of birch. It's a branch from an old birch tree, and the birch tree was this branch was almost dying, so I cut it off, and this piece, the centerpiece, that's the one I'm going to use, I think, for my spoon. And I'll show you how I'm going to make it. So hang on. Yeah. See inside? The grain. It could be a very cool and spoon. Then I will try to split it up. And then I use my little puka knife. It's very sharp. You can see that. The only place that's a problem is this, where there's been a little branch. But I think I'll make this for the spoon and this for the handle. So this one won't bother me. I just have to make it even, and then I can draw whatever shape I want on the spoon. An important thing is that when you're using wood, it has to be new wood. If it's dried, it's much harder to carve in, and the risk of its cracking is bigger. So I use fresh wood, but I've just cut off a tree. You see, this is going to be the foundation of my little spoon. Yeah, and I have these two spoons that I, this one I carved last year when I was in Norway, and this one I carved in the fall, in the autumn, some months later. The problem is this one is too big to put in your mouth, and this one is too small, so I have to make one that's in between these two. So that's my goal. I think I'll use this one for templates and try to make it smaller. Well, as you can see, this one is too big to draw, and this one is too small. So I'll take this spoon that I have with me on my camping. I think it has the right size, so I'll draw it after this spoon. And I'll probably make this a bit wider than this is too narrow for a spoon in wood. Now I have the shape of the, and I just draw down here. Perhaps I'll make it, yeah, I think I'll make it a little wider at the end. This is just for, so I have something to cut after when I'm beginning my carving. So the most important, it's the shape of the actual spoon in my mouth. You have to have some sharp instruments Perhaps this one I'll cut off here. Some sharp tools, I mean. Now you can see this little knife. It's very, very nice for carving these kind of things. I have full control over it, and it's very, very sharp. Now we are starting to get the shape of the spoon. You have to be very patient when you do this, and my middle name is Patient. You have to slowly find out which shape you want. I have in my head a rough idea, but it's when I'm carving that the idea is coming out and into the wood. And perhaps during the process I find out this is the wrong shape, and then I can make a difference.
Well, I found out I have a little problem.
You see these small holes? I think it's from worms that have eaten the wood. And if this hole is the same as this, it's a bad place to have my spoon. You can see that. This one is going right out there. Doesn't matter in this part, but this part of the spoon, if it's going all the way through, and I think it is, then it's no good. I have to find out if that's so.
For that I'll use my spoon knife.
I'll just see if... You can see the wormhole is going deep. I have to find out if it's going all the way through, or perhaps these two are connected. Normally I wouldn't do this at this moment because it's too early, but I have to see if that wormholes are connected.
Yeah, I found out that
this little wormhole and this one is connected. There's hole through, so I could use it if I wanted. It is a little bit high, so, but I think I'll split another piece of that wood and try to see if I can find without this worm's hole. The process is the same as I did with this one, so I won't show you that. I'll show you it when I'm at this stage.
Yeah. So I have
cut a new piece of
spoon I was starting on with the wormholes in. So now I have finished my next template, the one I'm going to work on, and until now I haven't seen any wormholes. So I hope this piece is without. And I've changed the design a little bit. I think this is more what I want as a spoon. I would like to have it in this shape. So now I'm going to work a little bit more on it, and you can see the shape of the wood is a little bit bended, and that's, I think it's cool. So I hope this one will be a good one. We'll see. Well, now I've taken my other carving knife and used that. It's a little bit easier to do when the carving is going to be very precise. But here you can see the shape of the spoon. I think it's coming all right. I think it's gonna be a cool spoon. This is not the final design. I have to make this much thinner, and of course I have to make the hollow in the spoon. But this is the rough image of how it's going to be. It's very hard wood in here. I have to be careful not to split it. Yeah, now I think I'm finished with this little spoon. I decided to make these hard to see. This carving is an old Nordic symbol for power of the gods. And I also made this one. Yeah. Now the final thing I have to do is apply some oil on it. Just regular olive oil or oil from sunflowers. When you do that, the magic happens. You can almost see it bringing it to life. Look at this. It doesn't have to be much oil, but the oil is bringing the color in the wood. So I just have to work a little bit here and here, and when I'm done that, I'll show you the finished results. Now I'm finished with my spoon, and I think it's looking very nice. It has the right shape, not too thick, and you can see the things I've carved into it. It was not an easy task to carve this. I think it's look very nice.